Nachiketa, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, one question. Copper crystallizes. Copper crystallizes. Right, the question. Copper crystallizes with face centered to big unit cell. Copper crystallizes with face centered to big unit cell, FCC. Copper crystallizes in FCC, face centered to big unit cell. Face centered to big unit cell means the number of atoms in that unit cell is equal to 4. That is equal to face center cubic unit cell. First of all, if the radius of copper atom is, if the radius of copper atom is 127.8 picometer, 127.8 radius of copper atom, that is equal to 127.8 picometer. Picometer, you have to put in centimeter, that is 127.8 into 10 to the power minus 10 centimeter. This is equal to 127.8 into 10 to the power minus 10 centimeter. If the radius of the copper atom is 127.8 picometer, comma, calculate the density of copper metal. Calculate the density. Calculate the density of copper metal. We know that density is equal to Zm upon AuMa. Ma is the Avogadro number. So we are writing capital A. For sodium, we write small a. Ma small a. For Avogadro number, we write capital A. So Z is given. Molar mass. Molar mass of copper is 63.5. You just write in the bracket. Calculate the density of the copper metal. Given that atomic mass of copper is 63.55 U. Bracket you write atomic mass of copper is 63.55 U. Once again, I'm reading the numerical. Copper crystallizes with face centered to big unit cell. If the radius of the copper atom is 127.8 picometer, calculate the density of copper metal. You have to find out the density of the copper metal. And given that atomic mass of copper is equal to 63.55 U. So what is the molar mass? Molar mass is 63.55 grams per mole. Okay. See here, Z is z value we know is equal to 4. So 4 into m. Molar mass, that is 63.55 grams per mole.
They have given in terms of U, in terms of atomic mass, but if you change that unit, you can get the molar mass.
Upon
AU, A is not given. Edge length or cell dimension, that is not given.
Instead, they have given R, and we know that in FCC, 4R is equal to 4R is equal to
4R is equal to root 2.
So you have to calculate A using this R. R is the first you find out A, and then A you substitute here.
So it's a huge calculation. Doesn't matter, you know the density of copper, it will be reaching somewhat that value.
Okay. So A you can calculate. A is equal to your A cube, that is 2 root 2 R is 127.8. We do 10 to the power minus 10 whole cube into Avogadro number, into Avogadro number, that is 10 is 6.022 10 to the power 23.
6.022 10 to the power 23,
and the number is getting 8.9 gram per centimeter.
This copper value is very important. For iron density is 7.8, copper is 8.9, and silver is 10.5. Okay, so you go through some refreshers and get more and more questions of density and solve. Next, we are moving to imperfections in solid. Imperfections in solid. Although crystalline solids are, although crystalline solids have long range order, yet the crystals are not perfect. The crystals are not perfect. Some have defects in them. This happens when crystallization occurs in a faster rate. Unit cell is formed when the crystallization occurs in very slow rate. Extremely slow rate. This imperfections or this crystal defects are of two types. One is point defect and the other is line defect. Irregularities from ideal arrangement around a point is point defect. Irregularities from the ideal arrangement around a point means around an atom. Point means for us an atom. Lattice point means you will see an atom over there. That is lattice point. So irregularities from ideal arrangements around the point is what? Point defect. But if you find that irregularities along a line, that is called line defect. Irregularities from ideal arrangement in the entire row, that is called ROW, that is called line defect. So two types, defects are of two types. Point defects and line defects. In class 12, we'll be learning only point defects. In degree classes and PG classes, line defect, plane defect, etc. So point defects. Point defects are again classified into three: stoichiometric defect, impurity defect, and non-stoichiometric defect. any foreign atom what enters into or purposefully what we add into the crystal, that is called impurity. Any foreign atom what is coming to the crystal, this can be accommodated how? First you melt the solid so that molten solid, that molten means that is a form of liquid. So to that molten state you add some molten impurity and mix it well and slowly let it cool. On cooling, this impurity, the foreign atoms replace some other atoms of the solid. That is how this impurity is included in the solid, included in the crystal, included in the solid. So impurity means a foreign atom. To the crystal, you can, means from the crystal, you can replace some atoms with foreign atoms. That is done by melting both, the required amount of impurity is added. You melt both, mix it and slowly let it cool. So some of the real atoms are, some of the atoms of the crystal, of the metal is replaced by the foreign atoms. That is equivalent. Next, NOx question. Stoichiometry means for this, these many positive ions, these many negative ions should be there. For example, Fe4, for one atom of Fe, one atom of O should be there. For 100 atoms of Fe, 100 atoms of O should be there. But instead of this 100, for example, this is only 96 atoms of Fe. That means stoichiometry is lost. Stoichiometry is a mistake. So this is called a non-stoichiometry. But in this defect, even if the defect happens, stoichiometry will not be. And there is NiO. For one Ni, there should be one O. For one Ni, there should be one O. Suppose metal is deficient. It may be 90. For 100, it may be 90. Or you can say for one, it is 0.98. Stoichiometry, begin there. So stoichiometry, that type of defects are called non-stoichiometric. Let's come to stoichiometric defects. Even if the defects takes place, stoichiometry will not be affected. For these many sodium Na plus, these many sodium ions, these many chloride ions will be. You know that NaCl. For one Na plus, there is one Cl minus. So for 100 Na plus, there will be 100 Cl minus. For 80 Na plus, there will be 80 Cl minus. So when one Na plus is lost, then one Cl minus is also lost. So previously, suppose there was Na 100 and Cl 100. One Na plus lost, same time one Cl minus is also lost. Then it is Na 99, Cl 99, same stoichiometry, Na 1, Cl 1, but it is not spoiled. So even after the defect also, the stoichiometry remains intact. Such type of defects are called stoichiometry. Of course, when the positive and negative ions go away, electrical neutrality is maintained. In the case of ionic crystals, always electrical neutrality is. Then it is maintained. Density will decrease because some atoms are, some ions, positive and negative ions are leaving the crystal lattice. So of course the density will be decreasing. In the case of ionic crystals, electrical neutrality is to be so social magnetic effects equal number of positive and negative ions are moving. In the case of general one, for example, boron nitride. So atoms are lost. Density decreases. This is not an ionic constant. So here, when some atoms are lost, of course, density decreases, and you see some vacancy. The vacancy. This is the vacancy. Call it as a vacancy. Generally, we can call it as vacancy defect. Generally, you can call it as a vacancy defect. But in the case of ionic crystals, for example, Na plus Cl minus, Na plus Cl minus, Na plus Cl minus. Next to one Na plus, there should be one Cl minus. Next to one positive ion, there should be Na plus Cl minus. This is an ionic crystal. From the ionic crystal, equal number of cations and anions are missing to maintain the electrical neutrality. Equal number of cations and anions are missing. You can call here also the vacancy. Na plus is lost and here one Cl minus is lost. Here also it is vacancy defect. But in ionic crystal, this vacancy defect is called shock field defect. This is called a Schottky pair. Na plus and Cl minus. Schottky pair. So, in the case of general, we can say vacancy defect. We have also used vacancy defect only, but specially we call it as Schottky defect in the case of ionic crystals. Now, in this case, density decreases. Now, sociometric defect is so one is vacancy defect. Vacancy defect. Generally, we call it as vacancy defect, but in the case of ionic crystals, we call it as Schottky defect. And another sociometric defect is interstitial. In this case, extra atoms will be coming to the interstices. You know that to occupy this interstitial space, void gap, that coming atoms should be small. Interstitial defect. Such defects are called interstitial defect. If an atom is present in the voids, in the gap, then we call it as interstitial defect. If extra atoms are coming, then of course it increases the density of the crystal. So if interstitial defect, the density. Now you can consider what interstitial defect in the case of ionic solid. In the case of ionic solid, if I write positive, negative,
negative, positive.
If the cation is very small, it can shift to the inner skies. So from here, it will shift into this place. If the cation is very small, for example, zinc sulfide, Zn2+ is very small, it can get into the ice or the voids. So here it is a KKC, here it is an interstitial. Anyway, this is considered as interstitial defect. So here it is a VTC, considered as interstitial. In the case of iron solid, this interstitial defect is called Prandtl defect. Prandtl defect. But in this case, density remains the density remains. Here also electrical neutrality is maintained. Since it is ionic, electrical neutrality is. This is called Prandtl. Shepardine defects are of four types. Vacancy defect and interstitial defect. In the case of ionic solid, vacancy defect is called Schottky defect. And in the case of interstitial defect, interstitial defects are called Frenkel defects. In Schottky defect, density decreases. In Frenkel defect, density remains the same. If the positive ions, means that the cations and anions are of similar size, then chances of Schottky defect is low. If the cation is very smaller, then chance of Frenkel defect. In both the cases, electrical neutrality is maintained. You just know now the difference is between Schottky defect and Frenkel defect. Two columns, Schottky defect and Frenkel defect. Number one, shown by crystals having same ionic sizes. Schottky. By crystals having same ionic sizes. That's right. Shown by crystals having different ionic sizes. Shown by crystals having different ionic sizes. Number two, density decreases. Schottky defect, density decreases. That side, density remains the same. Density remains the same. Schottky, this side, ions are missing. Ions are missing. Ions are missing. That side, ions are dislocated. Ions are dislocated. That is also called dislocation defect. Dislocation defect. Frenkel defect is also called dislocation defect. Here example NaCl, Schottky example NaCl, that side example ZnS. AgBr shows both Frenkel and Schottky. So AgBr you write in both. Sometimes the question comes, give an example which shows both Frenkel and Schottky defect. Example is, answer is AgBr. Next is,
impurity defect.
Impurity means a foreign atom. When it comes and replaces the already existing ion, then we call it as an impurity. This is an ionic crystal. Next to one Na plus, there should be Cl minus. Next to one positive ion, there should be a negative. Suppose I have melted this NaCl and I added it with SOCl2. So I have molten NaCl, molten NaCl, and I mixed it with molten SOCl. Na plus is having only one positive ion, one SR2 plus, that means two positive. So it can replace, means when one SR2 plus replaces these positive ions, two Na plus, two Na plus can be. So here there is a magnesium, and here there is a magnesium. In one magnesium, SR2 plus N. So give SR2 plus. Electrical neutrality. Oh, it is mandate, electrical neutrality. But you see, when the SR2 plus N is one magnesium, the number of SR2 plus is equal to number of vacancies, cation vacancies, number of cation vacancies. If you are putting on Al3 plus, then three positive ions will be utilized by one Al3 plus. That time two vacancies will be created in this NaCl. So that depends upon the charge, how many vacancies are created. So this is an example for interstitial difference. Instead of SRCl2, you can add CDCl2. So, AgBr, you can add AgBr means Ag plus. This AgBr, Ag plus, how many Ag plus? And Cl minus Ag. Two Ag plus can be replaced one by one CD2. So, when molten AgBr is mixed with molten CDCl2, how many cation vacancies will be produced here? How many CD2 plus are there? Those many. How many CDs? How many CD2 plus are there? Those many vacancies will be created. Thank you.